everybody, and welcome to Check Versus Mate. This is a new chess-based strategy game that has just come out on Steam, going for 15 bucks this week, but once that sale is over, it is going to be regular 20. Now, some of the more astute viewers might be like, chess-based strategy? I thought chess was already a strategy game. Well, smartass, it is, but this is like variations on chess. So it uses chess as a base. The rule sets for the pieces are exactly the same, but sometimes they will add different conditions, either of the board or of the pieces, that makes, you know, for a somewhat more varied experience. But in any case, we're gonna get started here. Very first thing worth noting is that there is just classic chess. So if we wanna just have, like, regular chess, we can just do that. We can set the difficulty wherever we want. 4 is pretty easy out of 10. We can set it on, like, a random playing field. And this is kinda weird for me. Some people may not know this, some people may know this, but I used to play semi-competitive chess when I was younger, like when I was in high school. I know, coolest kid on earth. But, yeah, I played, like, extensively for a few years, read a lot of books, got a lot of coaching, so my chess game is pretty solid. So this is the way that things look normally, just by default. We're playing as white here. I always kind of was turned off by reskinnings of chess pieces. Like, I think it just unnecessarily complicates things. Like, chess is a great game, but it's balanced and it's important to be able to see what the pieces are clearly. And sometimes here I get confused. Like, this is a bishop, sometimes it's hard to tell. This is a knight, I mean, obviously it looks like a horse. But anyway, just by using the tab key, we can switch to regular pieces, which is cool here. So we can just do moves. If you're not familiar with the rules of chess, well, then I apologize. I'm not gonna go out and explain them, just look them up yourself. You know, you should learn how to play chess. Chess is a great strategy game. But what I wanted to show off here is just that there is indeed the potential. How do I wanna do this? There is indeed the potential for, oh god, this is not what I want to do, I think. The potential for this to be played just as, like, your standard chess game. It's based on the Fritz engine, which, as far as I understand it, as you can see, if you have any knowledge of chess right now, the computer is not playing very well at all. It's like, well, when I was playing competitive chess, the dominant chess engine, at least for someone my age, was Chessmaster. So I was playing, like, you know, Chessmaster 8000, and that had a lot of... What am I thinking here? I'm moving too quickly. It's the problem. Like, if you think it's bad that, you know, I sometimes play puzzle games while trying to talk over top of them, well, it's not going to get any better if I am trying to play chess while talking over top of it at the same time. But in any case, we're going to see if we can get some action here in one way or the other. What should we do now? We can take that bishop, but it's not really the wisest course of action for us right now. Perhaps what we should try to do is maybe move forwards here. Actually, I should have done the other pawn. Oh well, there is an undo function as well. I mean, it's kind of cheap to use that, but if you misclick, then it's something that you can do. Then perhaps we can sneak in here. Like this? That's checkmate, isn't it? Yes, okay, so the computer is not so good at early levels, but you know, if you crank it up, I'm sure it'll get more and more difficult. But in any case, this is just to tell you that there is regular chess available in this game. There's also Battlegrounds. This is a little bit unusual. We're gonna go with Duel. And we'll stay with the same difficulty just to explain to you what's going on. We can also fuck with the placement, actually. Like, we could put the placement on Madness, let's say. I've never actually done this, so let's see what happens. We'll play on the white side again. You know what? Let's just play on a classic board so that I can understand what the heck is going on. Okay, so I guess the way that this works is it just places the pieces, you know, basically randomly, which is sort of interesting. And again, maybe it's my own personal problem here, but I can't really tell what the fuck is going on unless I change it here. So, okay, this is the way the board is meant to be orientated. Well, their king is over there, and our king is over here. So I might as well just explain to you what the heck goes on here in Battlegrounds chess. So basically, when we take a piece normally, like rook here on f2 could take the bishop on e2, no problem. But the way it works in Battlegrounds is you actually, after you do it, engage in a fight with the enemy. And then you have to go through this series of quick time events that come up here. So you'll see as these, like, DDR commands come through here. I will start doing some attacking. If I complete the sequence accurately, I'm going to shut up so I can do it. Seriously, that was like the longest sequence I've ever had to encounter in this game. But in any case, we did it fine. So yeah, you go through that series of quick time events. If you succeed, if you're the attacker and you take out all their HP, then you claim their square and the piece as well. if you're the defender and you win, which you will probably see right here, then basically they just lose some of their HP. So every unit has HP. It's not just like all or nothing in this version of chess. And they will relinquish their attack. So then you can attack them maybe on the next turn, depending on the pieces that you have, of course. All right, so that's going to be good enough to win the attack here. I think this game mode is really silly. I've never been a fan of variations on chess, like battle chess and stuff like that is really like not up my alley, but let's take this here. I think chess is already like a good strategy game in its own right. It doesn't need any extra rules that kind of compound it and make it, I don't know, I don't want to say more difficult because that's not necessarily true. I mean, if you're playing against like a chess master, obviously the game of chess that you're playing is going to be exceptionally difficult. But anything that makes it more complicated than is necessary, and anything that makes it longer than necessary. I mean, if you want to play a long game of chess, take your time and think of all the moves that you come across. Don't make it more, like, needlessly complicated with all this stuff. So anyway, that's my opinion of the Battlegrounds chess mode anyway. I haven't really messed around with it all that much because I played, like, one game and was like, this is stupid. I think in that game, basically what I did is I, like, took my queen and I just... Oh, that was bad. That's gonna hurt. Just hit the wrong button press there. I took my queen and just, like, took a pawn right next to the enemy king where normally, like, the bishop would be able to take me. But because I just took the pawn and then won the quick time event, then I just took it. Then I defeated the bishop in combat and then I just defeated the king in combat. So it took, like, three moves. In fact, you might be able to do that here. Like, watch this. So I'll move my queen up here. They're gonna do some rook-on-rook combat here. And we'll just see if we can exploit this a little bit. Because it seems to be so far, if you can win the quick time events, then it doesn't really matter. You don't actually have to employ any extra strategy. That was bad. You don't actually have to employ any extra strategy. It might be one of those things that works better in multiplayer, where you're not competing against the computer. But if I am playing multiplayer chess, I want it to be chess. I don't want it to be this weird kind of variety or variation on chess. That was an easy quick time event. That's the other thing I don't understand is that sometimes you get like 50 strings or a string of 50 inputs. And oftentimes you get a string of like 3 inputs or 4 inputs as you can see right there. Something about it seems very strange. So that will take off a lot of the HP of that rook. We lost some of ours as well. But here, watch this. So queen takes pawn. This is an awful move. But in Battlegrounds chess, I think we can actually make this work well for us. So we got Lucy Lawless on the left. Jokers to the right. And as you can see, it doesn't really necessarily seem tied to, like, the strength of your piece. Like, the length of the string doesn't seem tied to the strength of the piece. I think the damage you do is maybe tied to the strength of the piece. Now, the knight is going to take us. Normally in chess, that's how it would go anyway, but instead we get a chance to defend ourselves here. So if we defeat this knight, I think we can just then engage in battle against the king. So we should be able to do, I don't know, if we win, like, 3 strings here, it should be enough for us. And as you can see, like, the second one apparently is always only one input, which is very easy for me to do. Alright, so that was an incredibly easy defense. And now I think we can just go attack the king, and if we kill the king, we actually win. Which makes this seem to me very, very silly. Like, on the outside, it looks like, hey, maybe we'll try, like, different strategies. Like, you'll have to be more strategic this way. But it almost, at least against the AI, seems to take away from some of the innate strategy of chess. We're gonna be able to kill this guy in probably 2 or 3 strings. I don't know why he's holding PlayStation Move controllers. Don't ask me. So, up, left, left, up, 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 down, left, down. Oh, that was close. Okay, so now we've won. Despite making, you know, some of the worst moves that you could possibly imagine from a chess standpoint. So I think this actually takes away a lot of the strategy of chess. I checkmated them in 4 moves. I find that very silly. Battlegrounds chess not really my style. Admittedly, I've never played the slasher chess mode here. Let's go with standard placement, difficulty of 4. And of course we can crank up the difficulty, but you know, even a difficulty 4, you shouldn't be able to checkmate the opponent in 4 moves. It strikes me as a silly addition that doesn't really add anything to the general gameplay at all. Additionally, we will, as always, I do this every single time. Switch to the standard mode here. So we'll start with e4, standard moves, Sicilian defense. This might not be standard. It's been a while since I've played a game of chess like this. Let's just see what the slasher mode does. Okay. You control one attacking defending piece, which is supported by several pieces. Your objective is to destroy all the enemies. When you eliminate an enemy piece, your HP will increase a little. Okay. I kind of don't understand what's going on here. Oh, we're doing like WASD. Okay, this is really silly. This is the first time I've encountered that combat. Seems to work out A-okay, you know? We can do heavy attacks and strong attacks here. Or in light attacks here with the left mouse button or right mouse button. Do you really want this out of your chess game, though? I don't think so. And again, from a chess standpoint... Oh my god. Like, I don't want to deal with this shit every single time. From a chess standpoint, I like the engine here when I'm playing, like, standard chess games. Like I said, I think it's based on the Fritz engine, which is apparently, like, a dominant engine in the industry now. Or in the niche, anyway. We're probably gonna lose this. At least this seems a little bit more balanced. Like, it seems like the bishop can just absolutely tear me apart. Compared to, or maybe not. Compared to what was going on with the pawns before. Like, this at least makes a little bit more sense. But still, very silly in my own personal opinion here. Does that, I guess that probably took off some HP or something. Anyway, I don't like those modes at all. Now, the question is, like, why would you... I mean, I've mentioned that I think the chess engine for the single-player standard chess stuff is okay, but why would you ever buy this game if you don't want any of the variations? Like, assuming you're using a Windows computer right now, you have Chess Titans available in your games section, which is totally fine. Like, for 90% of the population, probably like 99.5% of the population, Chess Titans is going to be good enough and comprehensive enough for what you want to do, which is usually just like, play a game of chess while I'm taking a shit now and then. Now, there are also, what I'm trying to struggle with is who wants to buy this game. If you're a chess fan, you don't need to buy this game. You could buy Fritz directly. You could buy the newest version of Chess Master if you wanted to. You could just play Chess Titans. You could play online on a number of free sites. If you wanted, like, this variety of stuff, like, the variety is not good. It's not chess. So who out there is like, I like chess. I just wish it was a little bit less chess-like. Now, the one thing they do have that I find kind of cool is they have these campaigns. So the campaigns are basically... like, they'll give you one board and it's a puzzle, so let's check out maybe Smite Thy Foe. Actually, let's look at Fog of War. I don't like Fog of War. Let's look at something earlier, perhaps. Greed. I don't like this. Rage. Your piece. Okay, so there's Rage is a good one, for example. Your pieces must attack whenever they can. The opponent's pieces do not have to. So this is a condition that is... It kind of makes your game like checkers. I think Gilead is one I liked. Win before the timer runs out. Okay, so this is just like standard blitz chess. There's a little bit of a narrative that I just skipped over that is not important at all, at least so far. So we're just gonna try to checkmate the enemy as fast as we can. Might work out, might not, who knows? I'm obviously not worried too much about the actual quality of my moves, which is good because the quality of my moves has been absolutely abysmal so far. But I should be able to, oh no, snag at least a piece. If not a checkmate, like, right here. Let me think about this for a second. For like, literally a second. Now I think we can go up here. How do I want to do this? Let's start pushing this pawn up. Making some progress. I beat this one way faster. Like I said, the engine... pretty not great. When I first got started, this is not a good course of action on my part. How about this? This... and this will be checkmate here. Okay, so that was pretty not great. Like, if you're a chess aficionado, I think you're gonna find a lot of these puzzles very easy. Let's go check out some of the other ones that they have here. Promote any pawn to a queen is a victory. Pieces, this is a good one. Pieces will switch colors when they capture an enemy piece. So the way we want to do this one, you can see we start with just pawns. What we want to do is, like, put our pawns in enemy way here. So we'll just let the knight take that one. And we'll just, I don't know, move this pawn up. So the knight will take it, then it becomes our knight. And then it becomes our turn as well. So we'll move our knight out of the way this time, but we'll keep our pawn here. And basically what we want to do is, like, goad the enemy into, yes, exactly that. Giving us their queen is a good start. But what we have to worry about here is we can't just, like, take a pawn and checkmate the enemy, because obviously that will result in us losing our queen, for example. Like, if I took this pawn, I would lose my knight. My knight would become their knight. But I can probably get a bishop here. Yes. So that'll be check. Oh, I guess it was taken from me for some reason that I do not understand. So what we'll try to do is, again, just move some pawns up here. I don't want to lose my knight yet. but I can easily gain some power. Okay, that bishop should become ours. Then the knight might take it if I don't move it. Is this all making sense? I hope so. Let's do this. And this, maybe. Sure, why not? Got a nice little background for ourselves here. Oh, that's not good. I don't like that. What we can do is maybe sneak some action in here. I want to get this dude to take some of my shit. Like, okay, you can wait there. We've almost kind of gotten ourselves into sort of a stalemate here, but I wonder if I can move my king away and convince that guy to take some of my stuff. I just want to checkmate you, please. So the cool thing about the game mode like this is that, let me think about this for a second. About the game mode like this is that we have to, let's feed him this one basically. We have to think a little bit differently. We basically have to sacrifice our pieces, and then this will be checkmate here. We have to feed him our pieces and kind of think with a different move set, so, or a different rule set, I should say. So I think these are kind of cool. Some of them are terrible. For example, I spent about an hour of my 3 hours so far in this game trying to beat this one right here. So the way that this one works, this is the last mission of the white campaign, is there's a fog of war, so you can't see any of the enemy pieces, and you have to win in spite of that. So the only way you can see pieces is by... Actually, let's restart here. The only way you can see enemy pieces as we move along here is by using your pieces to kind of see where... Like, the bishop can see on diagonals like this, so we can see, okay, there's a pawn there. That's all we know so far, so we can put this one up there to match it. And then I like to maybe do something like this. And then maybe something like... this, because we have no idea right now what is going on the enemy side of things. So absolutely anything could be happening. Like, I can move this up and it could just be taken away from me on the next turn, right? So we lost a pawn there, but that's all right. Not the end of the world. I'm gonna try to, I don't know, move some stuff around here. It's not great. I mean, I'm obviously not doing normal strategy here. But I can't see what's going on. One thing we can do that's different in this mode is occasionally you'll get, like, reserve pieces. So I could just click on the spot on the board and be like, I want another white bishop right now. Or I want another knight. So let's put a knight right here. We can do that. We can also do the same thing. Put, like, a white bishop right here to protect this. So let's, I don't know, just start taking these pieces. We might have pawns that are going to take them from us. That's okay, though. Are we going to lose this rook? That's what I didn't want to have happen. Where's the king? Okay, so the one thing I don't like especially is that if you're in check and you don't move your king, you lose, which is totally against the rules of chess. But anyway, so that's one that I really dislike. There's another one that's like, the field is covered with deadly traps that you can't see unless your pawn touches them. So, like, you'll move a knight to, like, F6 or something, and it'll be like, or F3, I guess, and it'll be like, oh, by the way, you're dead. Your knight just disappears. So I think that's kind of stupid. But the campaign at least kept me entertained as someone who has a passing interest in chess and used to be somewhat proficient at it. But I don't think I'm going to be spending any more time with this game. The other thing it has is mini games here. So it does have, like, chess puzzles that must be solved in a single turn. Sure, let's, okay. Let's figure out how we get checkmate here. Is this what we wanted? Find the white move that captures the unprotected black piece in one turn. You may solve puzzles one after another until the timer runs out. All we have is a bishop. I don't understand what you want me to do. Okay, so we can take this, and take this. Is this what you want me to do? I have no idea what the hell's going on here. So you want to go like... Let me think about this for a second. I really do not understand what's happening. Did I fail that puzzle or succeed? I don't know. Whatever, this is silly. I can't believe I'm doing a let's look at of chess. Find the white move that checks the black king. Oh, this is silly. How about standard puzzles? Okay, maybe this is what I like. Checkmate the enemy. Oh, this is good. I like this stuff. Checkmate the enemy king in 15 turns to achieve victory. Okay. We can do this. Although I need, yes, to see it like this. So we'll start like this. 15 turns is not a long time. But that's okay. We want to move like here, maybe. Then we can move our rook down here to block a little bit. I've botched this a little bit. The board looks very strange to me right now. God damn it. Okay. I know it's what I'm... We only have one move left. I've fucking destroyed this. That was terrible. Okay, restart this. I've done this 1,000 times. I guess the way we want to do it is... Maybe like this even is going to be faster. So we're just trying to gradually limit the amount of space that this dude has to move around. And then get our king like exactly aligned with him. This is better. Oh my god, come on. I can't do it. I was one move away. Okay, give me one more chance here. This is silly. Why bother doing it in like X number of moves when I know it's gonna happen anyway? Well, this is easier, I guess. He's just gonna let it happen. So now I think it's pretty much guaranteed this time. Alright, that was way easier. And we'll see, these are just patterns that you learn when you play chess for a little bit of time. Checkmate the king in 13 turns. Okay, you know what? What do we have here? At the very end? I want to see what they've got. Master puzzle. Knight and bishop is a hard one. Bishops and king is pretty hard as well, but knight and bishop is definitely the most difficult. You got 40 turns, which makes sense. And master puzzle. Checkmate the enemy king guarded by 3 pawns to achieve victory. Anyway, this is check versus mate. I don't like it pretty much at all. There's a multiplayer mode I haven't touched because if I want to play... The only reason I would play this online is to play chess, but I don't need to pay $15 to $20 for a chess game to play chess online. I could just play chess online on Yahoo or World Chess Network or anything like that. So yeah, I have no idea who this game is for. The chess engine inside of it is A-okay. But I don't know. If you like chess, play chess. If you don't like chess, don't play any variations on chess. Like, if you're not a chess fan, this is not going to coerce you into playing it or anything like that. But in any case, as always, thank you guys for watching. I'm going to give this one a thumbs down. I'm pretty sure that this is not going to appeal to basically anybody. And it's expensive as hell, too. But in any case, thanks for watching, and I will see you next time.